If you know that you want to go to Greece, but you haven't got a particular destination in mind, it can be pretty tricky to decide where to go. With 15 international airports and 227 inhabited islands, you could spend hours trying to research the right place for you. In this video, we will show you 10 reasons to consider the popular destination of Lindos, which is a small coastal village on the island of Rhodes. We hope that this will help you decide whether or not this idyllic village has the qualities that you are looking for in your trip to Greece. If you're looking for somewhere to visit outside of school holidays, then Lindos is a good option for making your summer last just that little bit longer. Located on the east coast of Rhodes, which is one of the warmest and sunniest islands in Greece, Lindos sees average highs of 28 degrees Celsius in September and 24 degrees in October, so all being well, you will get some late summer sun. Another reason to visit Lindos is the beauty of the village itself. Dazzling whitewashed buildings line the charming narrow streets. You could easily spend hours meandering through the sugar cube maze, exploring all the nooks and crannies. The warren of flower-lined passageways take you past tiny shops, cozy bars, and inviting restaurants. The main streets do get fairly busy with day trippers, but if you're based in Lindos, you can explore the village in the evening when the crowds have left. Lindos could also be a good option for you if you enjoy being able to immerse yourself in the history of the place that you are staying. Starting with the village centre, those winding streets were built in such a seemingly haphazard manner to confuse pirates, and given how easy it is to get lost as a tourist, I can imagine that it worked pretty well. As you explore the village, you will come across captains' houses that were built by wealthy merchant seafarers from as early as the 16th century. Look out for their beautiful courtyards, impressive doorways, and pebble mosaic flooring. We couldn't talk about the history of Lindos without including the Acropolis, which sits high upon a cliff, watching over the village. You will enter through the 14th century castle of the Knights of St. John, a fortress whose foundations were built by the knights from the ruins of an old church. Within the walls, you'll be taken even further back in time as you explore the 4th century remains of the Temple of Athena Lindia. The towering pillars and monumental staircase leading up to the temple are really impressive and definitely a draw of visiting Lindos. Tickets are €12 per adult, which we thought was worth it. Unsurprisingly, the views from the Acropolis are amazing, which takes me to our next reason to visit Lindos, and that is for the viewpoints. From the top of the Acropolis, you can see the heart-shaped St. Paul's Bay, so take a moment while you're there to gaze over the beautiful rocky coastline and sparkling waters. Being set on a hillside, you don't even have to go all the way to the Acropolis to be treated with beautiful views across the village or the water. Another way to find wonderful views is from the large number of rooftop restaurants and bars throughout the village. For us, being able to dine above the streets on a serene terrace, gazing over the lights of the village is an absolutely fantastic experience. Relaxing during the day and romantic at night, the rooftop restaurants and bars were something that we absolutely loved about Lindos. Not only can you dine in a beautiful setting, but the quality of the food, in our experience, is also a plus for visiting Lindos. We tried as many dishes as our appetites could handle on our trip. Aubergine saganaki, stuffed fresh vegetables, souvlaki, moussaka, salad, and of course, being on the coast, there was plenty of fresh fish on offer. Our favourite restaurant of the trip was actually not one of the rooftop restaurants, although we did enjoy every one of those too. Our favourite was Oasis, located on the road leading down to the main beach of Lindos. This restaurant was very quiet, which I assume was due to the location, although it could have just been a one-off when we visited. However, this was our favourite meal of the trip and was great value. Another reason to visit Lindos is the nightlife. Whether or not the sort of nightlife you will find in Lindos is a positive for you is of course very subjective, but we found that Lindos was a wonderful combination of relaxed but with a buzz. It isn't a sleepy village that goes quiet in the evenings and has an array of bars to choose from, but it definitely isn't a party town. Our favourite bar of the trip was Rainbird Bar. Enjoy your drinks on a picturesque patio at the edge of the cliff. The stunning views over the bay make it a particularly good spot to watch the sunset. If you're researching a Greek island holiday, then you're probably looking for somewhere with a beach for you to kick back and relax. In Lindos, you have your choice of beaches. Firstly, there's St. Paul's Bay, which is the cove that you can see from the Acropolis. This secluded bay has a couple of small, low-key beaches and crystal clear water. Unsurprisingly, the chapel here is a very popular place for weddings, giving the enchanting location. The main beach in Lindos is a pristine sandy beach watched over by the Acropolis. The sea here is calm and shallow, you can wade out quite far before reaching deeper water, making it an ideal spot for families with children. And it has facilities such as restaurants, toilets, and showers. Even though the beach is popular, we found that there are plenty of sunbeds available for hire. And if you fancy something a little more active when you're there, then there are pedalos and waterboards for hire. Another reason to visit Lindos is the convenience of getting there and around. Firstly, Rhodes has an international airport, so depending on where you're flying in from, you won't have to fly into another island first. If you are really looking for the most straightforward way of booking a trip, then many tour operators, at least if you're based in the UK like us, offer package deals to Lindos. Secondly, if you're looking for a destination where you don't need to hire a car, then Lindos could be a good option for you as the centre of the village is pedestrianised, so you wouldn't be able to get around the streets by car, even if you wanted to. As for seeing the rest of the island, while a car does of course offer you more flexibility, the island of Rhodes is relatively small and Lindos is connected by public bus to some of the other areas of the island you may wish to visit, such as Seven Springs or Rhodes Town. Alternatively, you could join an organised tour if you would prefer. Finally, we thought that Lindos was a good all-rounder destination. For lazy days, there are high-quality beaches, and for days when you feel like exploring, then you are ideally located for sightseeing. It's lively without being raucous, and while overall Rhodes is probably one of the more expensive Greek islands to visit, there were budget-friendly options for accommodation and food available. We loved our trip to Lindos, but because I do want to give as fair a description of the place as I can, I do want to point out that Lindos is a very popular destination with tourists, so this does mean that if you're looking for a quiet village away from the crowds, the souvenir shops and the tour groups, then Lindos might not be what you're looking for. However, if this doesn't bother you, then Lindos could be a great choice for your next holiday. My first tip is for those of you who would like to stay right in the heart of Lindos, or at least within walking distance of the village. We noticed when researching accommodation that there were several resorts that had Lindos in the name that weren't actually within walking distance of the village. This might not be an issue for you if you plan to spend more time at your resort, but for us personally, we wanted to be close to the action. For our trip, we booked an apartment at Lindos Horizon Studios, which is a small, relaxed hotel perched on a hillside overlooking Lindos Village and the Acropolis. While not being right in the centre of the village, this hotel was only about a 10-minute walk away, albeit up a massive hill, and we found the location to be ideal. We do have a video tour of this hotel on our channel, which I will link in the description of this video in case you are looking for ideas for accommodation. My next tip is to get up early and visit the Acropolis first thing in the morning before all the day trippers arrive and before the temperatures start to soar. On our trip, the Acropolis opened at 8 a.m, but I believe ours are seasonal and can change, so make sure you check the opening times in advance. Once you are done and the temperatures have really picked up, spend the afternoon either at the beach or in a pool or relaxing in a cafe or restaurant, and then explore the streets in the early evening. Not only will the streets be less busy, but they look even more beautiful as the sun is starting to go down. Another tip is to wear flat shoes with a good grip, especially when visiting the Acropolis. As I have mentioned already in this video, Lindos is hilly, so you want to be wearing comfortable shoes for all that walking. While walking around the village, you will also find pebbled or uneven floors in certain places, and some parts of the paths, particularly on the way up to the Acropolis, have been worn down and have become quite slippery. I hope that we have helped you decide whether or not Lindos is the right place for your trip to Greece. If you do decide to stay in Lindos, then we also have a video from our day trip to Rhodes Town, which I will link in the description below. We have a collection of other holiday planning videos which will be building up over time, so if you're looking for more future travel inspiration, then pop on over to our channel and see what we have. Thanks for watching.